Good afternoon, guys. Kenny here, Brave the Wilds. So today, we're starting a brand new series on my channel, and it's going to be titled Cabin Renovations. School, I only have about about 4 days left of actual school, and then a few days of exams. So I'm going to be done, which means the summer will officially be starting, which means this cabin will become my top priority, getting it ready for this next camping season. Basically, right now, it's trashed because I did a lot of upgrades, or I'm going to be doing a lot of upgrades, so I had to rip out all the old stuff and get everything ready. So I went ahead and I've done two or maybe three of my upgrades for this season, and I have about 20 of them in mind. So as I make them and as we progress through the summer, I will do more videos in the cabin renovation series. And so it will be a separate part of Chapter the Hut, and that I'll show you, you know, how I keep this place upgraded as we get ready for the next season. So I'm really excited to show you guys that. And so, right now, it's completely and totally trashed. There's stuff everywhere. So, that's not really what I'm going to focus on. The first thing I'm going to focus on, and I'm going to show you, is my new system for the spark arrestor at the fireplace. I think you guys will think it'll be really cool. So, I'm going to stop talking, and I'm going to show you the important stuff. So, let me go ahead and pan the camera down, and I'll show you my new system for my spark arrestor. Alright, so as you can see, this is the same spark arrestor that I've had for a while. I bought it last summer at a yard sale for $7. It's a trifold system where it's got three different panels, and they all fold together, and then, you know, when you have your fireplace, you just lift it and set it there. I think that's a really bad idea because it's annoying to have to move it around all the time. So what I did was, if you saw in previous videos, I screwed one of the panels to the wall, and then I could fold out the other two panels to cover the fireplace. That worked okay until I had my cabinet system, and every time I would try and get over here and stand here and work, you know, like this at the kit, at the kitchen top, the countertop, I couldn't fold out the thing at the same time, and it was really annoying. So I decided, well, how can I make this roll on a set of tracks so that way I can just move it anytime I want? So I came up with a system to do that. And as you can see, it rolls very, very nicely. I have a track up here, and then I have a track down here. This track does not take any weight. This just keeps the bottom of it inside of a U, so that way it doesn't flap around. It sits inside there, so that way it doesn't get caught up on anything. And so you just pull it over when you need it, just like so. And then when you don't need it, you can easily do it and move it over just like that. Let me make sure it's in the camera for you. Yep. And as you can see, it tucks up beautifully right next to the cabinet. So I can do all the work I want right here, and then the second I need to move it, it tucks away and it's hardly even noticeable. And it actually finishes at the exact line of the 2x4. That actually worked out a lot nicer than I thought it would. And so this track doesn't take any weight, but it keeps this from moving around. And then you just slide it on over when you're ready. So I'm going to go ahead and take this off, and I'll show you how I made the wheels, or the casters that this thing rolls on, and then I'll show you how it tucks up underneath the cabinet.
Alright, well, I know the lighting in there is so poor that you can't see anything, so I brought this, I took it off the tracks and I brought it outside so you could see. But it's a very, very simple setup. It's got a block here, which holds the screws on the back side. Go ahead and show you that. It's screwed in through the screen right here, over to the back side, as you can see, just like that. And so that holds the block. And the great thing about that is it makes it very easy to adjust the height of this up and down depending on how high you want your screen to sit. So that adjusts very easily. And as you can see, all it has is a bolt that feeds through. This is just a circular piece of 1/2-inch plywood that I cut out. And it has a little sleeve that it sits on. I'm trying to show this thing as good as I can. It has a little sleeve right here, just a plastic sleeve that it sits on, and that creates the distance right there for the bolt, so that way it doesn't keep pushing through. It gives it some resistance. It's got a washer on the end of the bolt to keep the wheel from sliding off. Sorry about that, guys. And then all it does is it comes through here where I have a nut and a lock washer. So overall, it's a very, very simple setup that creates a very secure way to support the wheel, and then it can spin very easily. And so the track fits inside that U. The U fits right around the wheel, comes right here, down and in between right there, so that way this can roll freely and support the entire weight of the screen. So I have one right here, and then I have another one right here. Get that in camera for you. It's a very, very simple setup. So I guess now I'll take you inside and I'll show you the tracks up close.
All right, so I've got you back in the cabin now. I know, guys, the lighting's really poor. I'm going to try and brighten it as much as I can, but I'm coming up with a way to get some good lighting in here for the future in the summer when I keep doing these improvements. I'm just going to try and find a way to get some good lighting in here for you. But basically, now you can see it is back on the tracks. I forgot to slip it in this bottom channel. Let me go and do that. There we go. So, as you can see, the wheels slip into that U very easily, just like I showed you. And then they can glide right on the front. I have it secured to this 2x4 on the right side of the fireplace and this 2x4 on the left side of the fireplace. So that way, that will support all the weight. And then they can slide very, very easily. I mean, it just takes, you know, one finger to just push it. Very, very smooth. As you can see, I strategically left a gap between the cabinet and the wall and put this track continuing down there, but the countertop extends over the top, which means we still have all that counter space, but when we want this thing to stow away, it goes right in just like that. And if you can see, it ends right along the length of the 2x4. Perfect. So if you ever want to take it out, you just pull, and it comes right out to where it needs to be. Well, everybody, I hope you enjoyed that. I think it was a really, really cool project. I really like how it's just super easy to slide it and not even have to worry about it. And then just it stows away so nicely, and it actually looks really, really nice compared to what it used to be. So I hope you guys enjoyed part one of the cabin renovation series. I think it's going to be a really cool series. It should help out a lot of people who like to do this type of thing or are doing this type of thing themselves. I think they'll find it quite useful, and it'll just, again, we all learn together. I'm going to show you guys stuff, and hopefully you guys will leave really interesting things in the comment section for things that I could do or things that you've done yourself. I'm very, very curious to see that. So I hope you guys have a great day. Stay tuned and keep watching my videos. I'll keep putting them out. I'm never going to stop. My plan is this summer to really just crank out the videos and really give you guys a lot of content, a lot of fresh content, because I've been a bit stale lately with all my homework and all that. So I'm looking forward to getting really back into it and shooting a lot of videos for you guys. So take care, and I'll see you on the next one.